Welcome to day 300. Making Songbringer. You can tell I've been looking at stars. I love stars. I have not checked the witness. I'm going to. I can't wait. Totally gonna. It's on my list. The Witness by Jonathan Blow. That's right, it is. Today I'm gonna be introducing a new kind of people. These are the ant people. I'm gonna draw some. Just start by doing some pixel art. Been designing characters all. What's up, Hardboil? So I wanna get a good color for these ant people. What hue would they start with? Man. How you doing, Hardboil? See, they kind of have a reddish color. All right, cool. Got some inspiration to start with here. Let's take that orange color and this darker color. Yeah. Nice hues. Sweet. Okay. Where's these layers? Did the stream die or something? It's still going. Looks like it's all right. Yeah, your thesis is almost finished. Sweet. And so is your January game. Oh, can't wait to see it, man. It was difficult passing your nighttime without the streams. Sorry, man. I was in the zone. What's up, Boogie? What's up, Jonah? Platformer. Yo, hey everybody. So I'm just drawing a little palette for the ant people. What's that? Oh, there it is, V. Yes, the ant people. Totally. So, I've been writing all the lore for the whole world and designing the whole game. Yeah, I've designed like 9 different dungeons. I got everything ready to go. All the bosses are laid out, what enemies, all the game mechanics that are added to the world, each dungeon. The secrets, the things you have to figure out, the puzzles you have to get through in each dungeon. He starts the game with a cert on. They stand on 2 legs. They're actually people. They're actually people. So I'm going to start drawing this guy. Let's get an outline first. Ant people are like really thin in the thorax. No, not literally ants, but they look like ants. And they have ant powers and stuff. Yeah, so there's 9 different dungeons, right? There's also 4 different races of people that the game introduces. And I'll reveal those kind of like as time goes on. It'll be fun to be like, "Oh, check this guy out or that guy out." And every race of people has a male and a female too. And the male part of the race is more of like usually more of the warriors and stuff, and then the female is like sometimes, you know, I guess it's It totally depends on each race what kind of warrior they are. So there's eventually going to be a dropped lady. So that goat enemy will actually have a female version. And they complement each other. Ant-Man, right? This is the ant male. Go back to this inspiration. So how you guys been? How's everything? Will they have a pincer mouth? No, not quite. So it's a human race. It's actually a human race of people that sort of developed ant-like looks and stuff, but not quite totally ants. I guess maybe you should have a pincer mouth, huh? Let's try a pincer mouth. We'll see. How can I draw? Oh, let's get like slightly darker there. Too dark. Man, it's hard to give him that mouth. But yeah, here. Now he's got pincers. Man, it's been a minute since I used Photoshop. Like, where's the 10% orange? Start giving him some cool highlights here. Orange tints. Mutated people, it's more of they evolved this way. So the whole like lore of this universe is that it goes back, millions of years. Millions and millions of years. Eventually, millions and millions of years ago, there was a human race of people in the Milky Way galaxy, and they split off. They found their way off their home planet. They evolved enough to develop the technology to start spreading throughout the galaxy, and they seeded all these planets, right? So they seeded a planet full of people that eventually became, over millions of years, became more ant-like. So yeah, there's like five races of people that are all human, of human descent. So yes, human people ant-like, yeah. Yes, I think they can. Yeah. What would the front of his thorax look like here? Probably would bend out a little bit, huh? Hey, Wizard, I bought the game through on the bundle on January 25th. I was wondering when I was going to be able to play the game on Steam. Did you order, what kind of game did you buy? What level did you buy at, Chewy? Because I think I saw your email, right? You sent me a, I think you sent me an email on Twitch, right? Did you pre-order the game at the $64 level or what? Because there's a $64 level one is the one that you get to play right now. The 32 level is one you get to play in about a month, and the 16 level is one you get to play at the very end. Oh, if you do, yeah, so if you ordered it for $16, it's gonna be several months before you get a Steam code. Sorry, man. But you can always upgrade if you want. If you want to upgrade your $16 one to 32 or 64, you can play the game a lot sooner. What's up, T? Yeah, so yeah. I hope there wasn't any confusion there. You bought it on Humble Bundle, right? Yeah, there. Yeah. Humble Bundle's got only I think it's because of, did you buy it through the sale? Anyways, that's the yeah, that's the $16 version basically. What's up, our games? Oh, it's through my site? Oh, okay, cool. The beta's in February. Yeah, February 21st. It's 30 years to the day from the release of Zelda, the original Legend of Zelda. 30 years to the day. It was released on February 21st, 1986. Songbringer is going to go beta February 21st, 2016. Don't even know which bundle you have? I can look you up if you want. What does the actual planet look like? I'm thinking of throwing in an Easter egg to my game. Wow, it's a whole planet. You know, it's a whole planet. It's I guess it's sort of similar to Earth. You know, it's a similar to Earth-like planet. Thanks for reminding me about that, Hardboiled. I was gonna do that and I forgot. Where can I write that down? I guess I'll just put it on the Trello. Oops. This guy, I think he's gonna have a little bit of a darker color right in the middle of his throat. Let's actually, whoops. Oh yeah, that worked. Huh. Nice. Okay, there's the ant person that's kind of like, it's not a little too. He's deeper hues for sure. What's up, Tuck 10? Hello. Yeah, Trello's pretty great, right? It's great for tracking your project. Okay, so yeah, let's try this guy. Oh, I hate it when I get on the wrong layer. Yeah, that's oh yeah, deeper hues. So I'm thinking more of like a, it has like, he has like this darker red hue. Deeper. Yeah. And then this hue becomes sort of, we can keep it like that for now. Wait, what the hell? Where'd it go? Oh, here it is. Let's write this one down. Yeah, okay, so now I can use this hue too. Would there be any different, stronger ant people or just with different sprites? No, they're different and stronger. Yeah, there's lots of them. Yeah, about there's a male, there's a female, there's a like a I think there's a smaller or a darker or a Oh yeah, these guys have guns. That's right. And they teleport in. Oh yeah. Okay, so I like this guy's body and stuff, but he needs to be wearing this cool cloak that I got in mind here. Wait, why doesn't it seem red enough? Maybe he just needs to be darker. Oops. Is it basically the same colors or does it have a specific geologic feature? Oh, is it basically the same colors? Yeah, this I mean you've kind of seen a little bit of the game. It's basically the same colors, yeah, as Earth. Where can you see which bundle you got? Yeah, did you go into Humble Bundle and check it? Oh yeah, and if anyone wants to upgrade too, if you want to play the beta in February, you can upgrade to the 32 or whatever. I'll be totally flexible with that for sure. Yeah, I want his chest to puff out, but what I really want is for him to be redder first in areas. Let's try 20% this time. I guess I'll do a new layer. New layers confuse me all the time, though. Yeah, especially when. All right, so it's all right, but I'm gonna take that opacity way down. That's just a red. You know what? He's not dark enough underneath. There we go. That's pretty good, like that. What's up, Ladder Thief? Thanks, man. Thanks for the congratulations. Does the planet have a name? Yes, it's called Xera. Does the star have a name? Yes, it's called Bellatrix. It's an actual star in the Milky Way. And all this is on the Kickstarter page too. How do you upgrade? I'm looking at the home button, but I don't see that as an option. Chewy, you can PayPal me the other $16. I haven't created a button for that yet, but Let me make sure I'll add that to the Trello too. Just to remind myself to do this later. Okay, it's cloak time. So I'm thinking his cloak is around the same hue as his brown, but gets a lot lighter. Wait a minute. All right, yeah, it's time to merge these. I hate it when things get too confusing. Merge. There. Ah, so much more simple. Okay, I want him to have a cloak. So taking this sort of this color. Getting a lot lighter and then less saturated. And changing the hue so it goes more towards yellow, not green. There, it's pretty good. But now it's too bright. Yeah, sort of like in here. So this is kind of going to be his cloak color. Ooh, it might be a bit too dark. Not enough contrast with the background. Oh, wait, or did I just draw it with like 20%? Oh, I drew it wrong. Oh no, I lost the color. Oh, damn. Shoot, it was I guess it was more saturated. Oh, this sucks. Oh, we gotta start over. Damn. Okay, so once again, brighter, less saturated, hue more towards yellow, more saturated than that. Less saturated. There. So now that's too bright. Oh, just yeah, if you want the my email, totally Chewy. Here, sorry, I wasn't paying attention there for a second. My email is nat@wizardfoo. Did you ever receive a reply from me for translating? I keep getting a failure at the time. No, I haven't. I've never got a reply from you. Man, that's weird. I wonder why. You could always tweet or text or I mean, what is it called? Private message me. Is it called private message on Twitter? I don't know. You could do that. What's up, Azarus? Oh, I'm doing good, man. I'm doing really good. Yeah, I've just had like these amazing 2 days of inspiration. I filled up pages full of like ideas for the game. So like there's all these different gates. There's like just this world with this boss, this dungeon with this boss, another dungeon, another type of dungeon, another type of people. Another dungeon, another couple dungeons, like a scene where I want to do a poster idea for about like when the game releases. I'll probably get to that scene. But today, and for the next week, I'm going to be working on this, the ant people. this dungeon. So I'll be doing this week, I'll be doing like new enemies, new game mechanic where enemies can be invincible around another enemy. You get mines in this world. There's these ant people. There's a boss. So that's my goal for this week, to see all that stuff. What's up, Salad Donks? Cedric, what's up? Yeah. Yeah, it's a great notebook. I like it too. You can't see them? Yeah, they're on Twitter, some of them. Some of the ant people. Okay, that's great too. That's a great question, because some of these, all these different races of people, all these human descendants, some of them are good, some of them are bad. The people I'm drawing right now are bad. So these are like the bad ant people. So I'm getting some more cues for his cloak. Yeah. So he's got like a staff. Just duplicate this layer here. Save that. Merge these. Oh, I hate working with two layers. Two layers get so confusing. So, oh yeah. Are they super strong? They're actually super smart. Can you step on them? No. Magnifying glass. But yeah, you get a mail delivery failure. Oh, okay. All right. That's so weird. I don't know why you get a mail delivery failure. I wish I would know, because it would be cool to know what's wrong. It makes me worried that other people were trying to send me emails, you know, and that they're not coming through. Mail delivery failure. If you could, maybe if you told me on, if you PM me next time on Twitter, you could tell me what your failure was exactly. What's up, KX? Yes, Teak, of course. Please share your game. Whoa, cool. What are these little entities? What if the ant people have an ambush strategy like fire ants? You can have a mysteriously empty screen that when the player walks in a particular area, it spawns a bunch of ant people who burst through the earth from the underground. Oh, Salad Dogs, it's a really cool idea, but that's almost the same thing is going to happen in a different dungeon with the Zurubs. So that moment will come. The game will have that. If they're super strong like ants, they should one hit kill the player. No, they're not super strong. They're super smart. Remember, they're humans, but they're just slightly more ant-like. They have these big old antennas that allow them to communicate with each other like telepathy and stuff. So they're really smart. What's up, Nug Troll? Cool, swarm based, huh? Yeah, so they also have like these really long chins. So their chins are like super duper long and straight like that. And they shoot guns too. They have guns. So wait, he has a staff and a gun? Yeah, he has a staff and a gun. All right, now I'm gonna do one where he's looking left and firing his gun. Yes, Jim can get hit now. How is it made? Which language engine? This game? It's Cocos 2DX. It's the language is called C++. C++, familiar? Yes, exactly. Ant with the human brain and Wi-Fi attached. Oh, sorry, you were asking. Oh, sorry about that. Did you get my email? I'll be showing you everything on video. Yes, Hardbold, I did. I'm sorry I haven't replied to any emails this entire weekend. I've been doing game design. I've been busy with that, and so busy that I didn't want to like distract myself with any mundane tasks like checking email. But I know it's important. I'll get back to it. I'll get back to it tonight in my regular habit of checking email every day. Oh, that's crazy. I like seeing him like that. Yeah, I like this. Like a big old black gun like that. Boom. Let's give this some like cool muzzle flare and stuff. Oh, not guns. Like, not actually, like, these aren't actually. What do you call them? Regular guns with bullets. These are like laser shooter plasma-y guns. By the way. Oh, whoops. I drew this with the wrong opacity again. Wrong opacity kills me every time. Okay, there's one nice muzzle flare filter. Do some like Gaussian blur. Oh, that's way too much Gaussian blur. Little more. Oh, a little too much. A little too much. There we go. Yeah, there. Something like this. Is that an ant-sized raincoat? Yeah, been working on your game? You been sick? Oh. Yeah, I know, right? Just those antenna. Yeah, he does look like a desert warrior, right? Did he shoot first? Boba ant? It's a pew pew ant? That's cool, man. So I want to do this like this like you know when you fire a gun and it's got kickback. Whoops. Oh, I hate that feature. The feature of Photoshop where you unselect stuff and it like deletes it. Think this will work. This guy just like moving back a pixel. Fires the gun. Let's see what that looks like animated. Dude, what's going on? My laptop's fan's on. Activity monitor cannot be taken 70%. Game show helper, game show helper, game show. So just game show? Are you minimized game show? Here. Okay, let's see what this looks like animated. So I'm gonna draw a first frame. Let's see. Okay, so first one he's like that, then there, this slight kick, then back to here. All right, so he's here for like half a second, here for a tenth, there for a tenth, back to there for 2 seconds. Repeat forever. Let's see what that looks like. Okay, more kick, more kick. Maybe a third of a second there on the kick. Maybe one more frame in here. Both of these like 0.2. Maybe this is 0.1 actually. And then one more frame of it. Where there's no muzzle flare. I guess we could go one more frame where he's got like halfway through from there to there. Something like that. What's up, Lance Maker? Why did I stop using OBS? Because it didn't have the audio in sync. The audio was like way out of sync. It was really bad. It was horrible audio quality as well. I had to record through my laptop speakers because it can't record system audio. All right, Jonah, see you, man. Check out your book for this language. You mean C++? Fifth frame looks odd. Yeah, it doesn't matter. I just wanted to sketch this guy out. So there, I've got an ant person sketched out. Let's do an ant woman really quick too. Ant female. Okay, so in this race of people, these are the human-ish ant people. They in this instance, there's other races of people where the women are like really sexy and stuff. This is more like the women are almost androgynous in this race. The women, like, you know, I guess they have, you know, they have titties, but they don't really have anything else. They're sort of like stick-like. Oh, and the women. Women have like a different kind of cloak too. Okay, so this is ant female, right? Yeah, ant female. So I'm gonna turn her to the side. Oh, does she have a gun too? Yeah. Both the male and the female have guns. Let's say she doesn't have a staff though. I'm going to turn more to the side. She's got a gun too. Oops. Nice. Yeah, I didn't design any different like compliments yet though for the females to the males. Like, it'd be nice for, you know, when you encounter this type of enemy, it'd be nice for like the males and the females to have some kind of like complimentary action. Like, for example, the drop. Wait a minute, no. I don't know. Maybe they'll get stronger. Oh yeah, like the frog people. They the woman makes the man bigger and like have more health. What's up, social username? Where have you been? How did it go with the first release? I've been doing game design this weekend. I took the weekend off and I designed a lot of stuff. I got pages and pages worth of different dungeon ideas and enemies and bosses and items and all the stuff that's going to go into Songbringer over the coming months. And this is not the first release. This is like the fifth release of Songbringer. It's actually the alpha. And finally, the beta is coming up in March or February next month. Yeah, and it went really well. What's up, Stadoff? No, she does not have just one eye. I think they're... Oh, yeah. Maybe I should draw those. See, this is confusing. She has two eyes, but I don't want to separate them. When she's looking straight at the camera, she'll look like this. You know, something like... Or like, you know, maybe like that. Okay, maybe she'll just sit like that. No. I want her at this angle for this shot. Like that. Okay, cool. Now I got these ant people sort of sketched out. I want to start doing some ground textures for this dungeon. So I'm just going to jump right into like drawing a brand new dungeon. Sprites. Wait. What happened to everything? I installed this Tinker Tool utility or something like that, and everything got... I lost everything on my shortcuts and everything. Damn, I was kind of relying on those. Raw. Sprites. Level. Should be like one ground. Yeah, one ground. All right, let's put the player in a point in the world where we can start to see this too. So I'm playing Mega Seed Fresh. I want to go to Dungeon 4, I guess. I'll turn the world so that it has a Dungeon 4. Sort of like stone. So this is the ant dungeon. We call this ant type dungeon. Style car 4. Number of rooms, more. Let's say this dungeon has... Oh, this totally depends. Oh, yeah. 16 to 35. Same number of keys, that's right, yeah. Okay, I can keep its colors and dirt and everything for now. And then, but I want to go foreground for its texture. No glow. Okay, let's see if that even works. It should have empty ground now. Oh, got to use that style. So in the world, right now it's all hard-coded, but eventually these are going to be randomized. So like some of the dungeons will be first. Like there will always have to be a certain dungeon that's first, like the drop dungeon, because that's where you learn to get this one item. And it's like critical to get this one item and everything. And dungeons are going to be tied to a certain item to make it more puzzly, more Zelda-like. The first three dungeons are like this. The last three are not like this. But so they have to come in order. But... For now, I think I could just change. Yeah. So dungeon 4. Let's call this one the ant dungeon now. Yeah, I had to take some time off, totally. Yeah, I was really stressed out last week. It was a lot of work getting that alpha out to just even that point. All right, great. We've lost the entire floor. That's what we want. And also, let's go to... Actually, first, let's... Yeah. We can turn off world.txt. I want to turn off the grass in this dungeon. So the ground, I'm gonna turn the grass shapes. Turn those off. And here, I can just export this. Actually, first I'll save it as, this is foreground. Foreground already exists. I forgot I had foreground. Oh yeah. No, I'm not even gonna use that one. Okay, let me put these on the deck, like somewhere else. Level. Foreground. I don't know what to do with these right now, so I'm just throwing them somewhere else. Unused dungeon. Now I can call it foreground. And then export render video. Not render video, but. Oh no, that's not gonna work. This all needs to be set up. Come on. Ah, what's going on? Ah. What the hell? I wanna edit this slice. Let go of the slice! Let me edit it. What the hell? What the hell? Why won't it let me change this? I want to edit the slice. Oh my god. What the fuck? How big is my screen? What? This is a regular size screen, 2500 pixels by 1600. Oh man. Why can't I edit this slice? Oh my god, there it goes. What the fuck? Man, sometimes I hate Photoshop. Just wanted to be artistic. Has to throw this whole technical bullshit in here. There. Save that. Sheets. Level. Foreground. We should have these files. Yes. Good, good, good. 0 through 8. All right. We've got the textures repacked. Now that's there. So that should be. We should have ground again. Right, thief? What was with that? Good. Everything is broken. Everything is broken. Because we're in a different world here. Okay. So first thing, I want to do the floor. The ground of this whole area has all these stripes and interconnected things going all over the place. Okay. Merge all these layers. There, simplicity. Simplicity, one layer. One layer is so nice for making pixel art. Oh my God. All right, I want to save this thing's palette. This is a good, actually, range of values. There. So I'm gonna work with those values. I believe this is the top. Oh yeah, that's the edge of one tile right there, the top of one tile. So funny how it looks flat instantly. But it was the same amount of pixels. Ah, this is how art works. Color ramps, yay! Kind love creating a little palette. I think I changed my mind. I want this to be a more outdated than indented. Yeah, the bamboo's still alive. It's still alive. That one time it stopped working, I glued something and it suddenly worked again. And then yeah, so it's still been rocking for the whole rest of the year. This $80 thing from 2011, I think. It's definitely been used. It's definitely been used and abused. Yeah. I feel pretty lucky. Still have it. They're on Twitter. Sketches I did yesterday. Yeah. Man, my computer sounds like it's about to take off. What's up, Zanger? Howdy, howdy. Yes. What's up with that? It's so funny because I think it's Photoshop is doing it. Photoshop, whenever I use the pen tool, when I'm just drawing pixels, it's like Photoshop goes into high gear, uses as much CPU as it can. It's like, it's got a nervousness about it. Four, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. It's like, yeah. I know, the pencil tool. It's the simplest tool. That's what's so ironic about it. All it does is draw without doing any kind of crazy blending. Try a sprite. I've heard it's great. I don't know if I want to switch at this point in my project, though. It would probably take me a week to go get used to something new. You know, I can't really spare a week. What's up, Cedric? Are you taking off? All right, see you, man. Good night. I know, right? The due diligence and optimization. Oh, it feels like Photoshop, really? You wish you'd get my laptop cleaned? It could be, maybe. I don't think so. I know, the fire seems out of place, yeah. Wow, nice. Can you please don't drop it? All right, Lighter Thief, see you, man. Good night, good night. Yeah, things like the fire and stuff like that, it seems out of place for a minute, and then, you know, eventually I get everything working. Everything will seem out of place for a minute till all the art starts to coagulate, coalesce into something nice for this dungeon. You find the problem with this is the bottom vents, the edge of the case. Bottom vents at the edges of the case. What kind of laptop do you have? Is this where we find Leonidas and the rest of the 300? It is kind of like that, huh? You switch from Monogame to Cocos 2DX, really? Starting to get there. Yeah, starting to look good. Starting to look good for sure. I'm thinking these middle ones have a little bit of darkness applied to them. Except for, well, actually, first we'll see how that looks. Plus one for reading rainbow. Yeah, that slight bit of texture really helped. Okay, and now I want the edges to sink in a little bit. I want it to start to look 3D. So I'm putting a little dot in each corner to signify that this is sort of a raised platform. I want to do it ever so slightly though. Ooh, that didn't look that good. I guess they need one pixel on the edge. So, boo to that layer. What's up, Rocket Bunny? No. How do you compile Coco City X on Windows? You open up the project. First thing you need, Visual Studio. You gotta go get Visual Studio, and then you gotta open up the Visual Studio solution file. It's got a .sln file on the end of it. And you open that up, it's in Coco City X's build folder. And you go in there, you open up the build folder's solution file, and you just build. Interesting. Yes, that works, that one single pixel, but didn't work with this. Gotta get a drink of water. Be right back. Sounds too easy. Yeah, you forgot to wait 7 days. Let's dive into some new territory right now. I want to do some. I think the lights now. They're, you know, you got these little pillars holding fire or whatever. So let's do some light pillars. The fire is not. I don't think I'm just gonna have fire though, but it'll have some other kind of fiery glow. I think the entities, there's a light pillar entity. Yeah. Oh yeah, it's the style pillar number. So hey, my favorites came back. Oh, dude. Wicked crazy. Yeah, Rocket Bunny, I'm so glad you like Game Maker. That's cool. Even kind of look good there already. Now I want to make a statue. Make this a lot taller. So it's going to be an ant person standing on top of a pillar. We need the ant. I want to get the ant male. How tall is that? That's a height of 37 minus a few. So we need to double, we need to get this up to like, I don't know, 80 tall. These guys,
Oh, yeah, he did have a.
Whoops. Oops. Windows has EXEs. What does Mac have? Mac doesn't have an extension for its executable files. Neither does Unix. In Mac and Unix, these are based on the Unix-based languages. These are a different kind of language or a different kind of file system, which has way more comprehensive permissions. For every single file, it has different permissions for the person who owns it, the group that person belongs to, and then everyone else. So if you wanted to set read and write permissions for yourself, you can set a file to be that way. You can set it for your group to be whatever you want. Like maybe you want your group to not be able to read that file, or you want everyone to definitely not be able to read that file, but only you to be able to read and write that file. And then every file also has an executable bit as well, so you can set whether it's executable. So in Windows, or excuse me, in Mac and in Linux, all you got to do to make a file executable is to just set the executable bit on it. It's very easy. And then and that's what's great about that too, is you can also control who executes things. Like a person, you know, an owner can execute, a group can execute, or everyone can execute. So that's why one of the reasons why I love Unix so much. What's going on here? Oh. Darkness. That's what's going on. All right, let's see how that looks in the game. This one will be 4, statue 0. And I think that should make the statues appear. Oh, wait, I forgot to repack. Oh, wrong color. What color type is this statue? Oh, it's a statue dungeon. Add statue, color type rock. These guys might be a little too small. And colored wrong. How did I get colored wrong? Yeah, it's the same color. Oh, maybe it's the code. Maybe there's something special in the code which does different colored statues. Oh, there was. Damn it. All right, here we go. Statue tile. Statue dungeon. I think it's changing the color there. How many coders are in the channel? I'm a code monkey. Vote. Check it out. What's up, code monkeys? Yeah. Let me slice open this tauntaun. I'm gonna crawl in. Mac executables are... Back to the future, right? Pixel of sweet square? Nice. Art frustrates you more because it's never technically finished in your eyes. Yeah. It's hard. You really gotta have that balance of being able to let go of your art and start something new. What's up, Artemis? cool, Salad Dongs. Dang. It's a whole city. Whoa. Yeah, as long as you're generally happy, then that's great, right? Yeah. Why did these guys change colors on me? Themselves. It's looking too busy. The ground's too busy. Yeah, these are all the same hue. Maybe it's the light pillar tile. Light pillar. Glow key. If I turn off the fire, maybe it's the fire that's giving it that hue. Rick Wild, I wasn't happy with my art until I realized the power of shaders. Yes, shaders can change everything. They make your stuff look good. Oh, wow, it was that thing. I mean, it was the light. Wow. Just like that. Shaders right here, changing the way this color looks. So definitely the ground is looking too busy for me. It's kind of a cool design or whatever, but it needs to be toned down or something so that the background should be the background. The foreground can't be the background, you know? It's like the background's looking too foreground-y. It's taking away way too much energy from what should be sort of an interesting thing here with these ant pillar things. And once I get a good pattern for these, I can do a bunch of them. But yeah, I gotta get some lunch, guys. Gotta get some dinner. Yeah, it looked cool without the lights, huh? Yeah. This level's gonna have some different kind of lights. Like, there's probably not... There might be fire for some of it, but definitely not all of it. But yeah, I got a lot of work ahead of me tonight, but that's all for today's stream. Yeah, this is the world with, this is gonna be the ant world, so this is full of ant people. So I drew some sketches today. I got a pillar sketched out, some ground sketched out, an ant male. So this is like the male guy. Let's go to his, I drew out one quick little drawing of him. Where was it? There. So it's just a little animation of him, like he's got a gun, he fires it. So yeah, that's it for today's stream. I gotta get some food and keep making art tonight. Thanks, Happy Moose. I know, right? Yeah, Link to the Past. I started playing that recently too. Yeah, the value down a little bit. Totally. Just changing the value would probably help a lot. Actually, let's try that really quick before I go. I'll do one quick value shift on that. Like all of this, make it darker. Quick solution. Maybe negative 30 or so, like that. What do you think of the game? Attack of the Mutant Fish Crows? I don't know, I never heard of it. Would the ant guy be without the robe? No, he's gonna have the robe on. You want him without the robe? That's, nah, see, it still needs more taken down, even on the foregroundy parts of it. The pattern's cool, but the pattern needs it to be less competing with the other stuff. So, yeah, see you guys. Have a good night. Enjoy yourselves. We'll be back tomorrow.